Hey, what's up? It's your boy, 24/7 here with 24/7 Fusion Media. And it's funny how Wonder Woman 1984 has came at the end of the year and has left such a bad taste in everybody's mouth. One of the complete failures of the movie, in my opinion, is Pedro Pascal. And to be real, he did a very shitty job as Maxwell Lord. But it's funny that I say that because in this Entertainment Weekly article, Pedro Pascal briefly forgot he was in NBC's very risky Wonder Woman pilot. Back in 2011, there was a Wonder Woman pilot that was created, put out by NBC, and he was in the movie. And it's funny how he shielded so much, you know, of course he's in the movie, but he was just so happy that he was able to get his character, Maxwell Lord, to be an influence of Trump, be influenced by a Trump-like figure, and all this other shit that wasn't necessary for the movie. And he preferred that. Wonder Woman 1984 over this NBC pilot. This is what I'm going to do. I'm going to show you his involvement in the pilot because I have a clip of him in it. I'm also going to show you a small little clip, and I went through so many videos to find this, but it's a small little clip of what we could have saw in 2011 NBC's Wonder Woman. So just sit back, chill, and let me show you something here. Look at that. In 2011, that would have been our Wonder Woman. And shit, I would have been perfectly fine with this. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Gal Gadot, you're good. But, hey, she's good too. So, It says, for Pedro Pascal being cast in Patty Jenkins' Wonder Woman 1984 was such an incredible moment that he briefly forgot he'd previously been in another project centered around DC Comics' Amazon Warrior. In 2011, Pascal appeared in David E. Kelly and NBC's failed Wonder Woman pilot starring Adrienne Palicki as the titular heroine. Pascal played Diana's liaison to the LAPD, the Commissioner Gordon to her Batman. Yet that experience was far from his mind when Jenkins offered him the role of villainous Maxwell Lord in Wonder Woman 1984. Well, damn. My whole thing is, how could you forget that you were already in the Wonder Woman movie? What it was, since the pilot failed, you thought Wonder Woman 1984 was going to do better? Well, guess what? Pedro Pascal is a part of two failed Wonder Woman projects. And he tried to act like he wasn't a part of shit. He should be trying to forget that he was a part of 1984. Did y'all like to see old Pedro in there? To be honest with you, from the way Pedro was looking, I would have rather had seen him in the Wonder Woman NBC 2011 movie. I would have rather have seen him in there than seen him as this bullshit ass Maxwell Lord. Boy, I tell you. Pedro Pascal says this: getting Wonder Woman 1984 blew my mind so much that anything that had ever happened to me prior, I don't recall. I had no association. Pascal recently told EW, Entertainment Weekly. Oh my gosh. And that's not to say that getting the Wonder Woman pilot from 2011 wasn't a party for me, and I was devastated it didn't get picked up. So that's what happened. It didn't get picked up. That happens to pilots all the time. People make pilots, and that's all you'll get. It's funny, he just decided, you know, that's what they call it, selective memory, where you just, hey, I did a Wonder Woman movie before, but now, fuck it. You know, since it didn't get picked up, it just, I don't even think about it. The Perspective series reimagined Diana as both a Los Angeles-based superhero and as alter ego Diana Themyscira, the leader of a large corporation that merchandised the Wonder Woman brand to fund her crime-fighting side hustle. Carrie Ewells, Elizabeth Hurley, and Tracy Thorns also starred. I love Adriana Palicki, said, I love David E. Kelly, and I thought it was a very, very risky and interesting take in terms of what they were trying to do, said Pascal. And the feeling is mutual, according to Palicki. He's just a sweetheart. I really, really enjoyed working with him. What a kind person from the beginning, Palicki told EW in September when we spoke to her about the pilot. Pascal believes the pilot slipped his mind because of the overwhelming culture impact of 2017's Wonder Woman and how excited he was about reuniting with Jenkins, who he has admired since 2003's Monster and directed him in the 2015 pilot Exposed. It's only after being cast that I start to remember the association and the strangeness of being part of two different Wonder Woman experiences, because the first Wonder Woman that Patty and Gal Gadot made together with Charles Roven took a dominant position in every sense that in many ways, he said, you can never say this was the only Wonder Woman, because Linda Carter will be with us for the rest of our lives. But in terms of our current era of superhero movies, it seems like there was nothing before this Wonder Woman. So to be in the next one was bonkers, because I also did the pilot with Patty Jenkins that didn't go to series. Oh, shit. He continued, I can remember what theater and what time of night I saw a Monster. It was 19th Street on Broadway in Manhattan, and I went to the stall of the bathroom after it was over to let out more crying because of how it affected me. So she was always a hero of mine and no one I expected to meet. Doing that pilot with her, the idea of getting to meet Patty Jenkins in the audition room was really, really big deal for me. So I couldn't have imagined getting to work with her like I did in the next Wonder Woman project. And seriously, it was one of the best experiences of my life. Look, I tell you what. Since we've sat here and just seen that this dude here was a part of two failed Wonder Woman projects. Man, I don't even fucking know, man. Pedro Pascal is just a piece of work right now. I just can't fuck with him. He's total douchebag to the highest level. So fuck Pedro Pascal. All he does is try to treat the fans shitty. So he can go fuck himself. Hey, what do y'all think about Pedro Pascal being a part of two failed Wonder Woman projects? Me? Oh, shit, man. I'd say fuck him. You know, he's been a douchebag. And I couldn't care less, you know, about his career, to be honest with you. In The Mandalorian, he's borderline mediocre. You know, all the shit that you see is all stunt doubles. He just goes in and does the talking. There's nothing special about what the fuck he does. I don't really give a shit. But y'all let me know what y'all think about this shit in the comment section below. Please, share, like, and subscribe if you haven't already. It's your boy, 24/7 with 24/7 Fusion Media. And I'm out. Peace.